Shalom, shalom. It's the foul mouth Kahan, and I'm back. And I'm pissed off. And I'm going to give you some right knowledge and some real remedy for the truckers that they trying to come against. Kadar's in the building. Shout out to everyone that has the heart to tune in and speak up. And again, I'm calling on all men around the world to sign this petition so that we could go against this family, this unjust family court system. The same way that you see the truckers boycott in New York City, which is rightfully so, is what you have to do as men. If you are men, and I believe that you are, and you have actually been victimized by this unjust family court system, it's time to stand up. And if you're not a man that's been victimized, then you definitely know someone that's been victimized by this family court system, and it's time to stand up. The petition is in the room. Join the movement. Join the movement. Men against the family court system. Sign the petition. The link's in the room, man. Share this video, like this video, and subscribe to the channel. This is the home of the truth, man. Right knowledge prevails. I'm your host, the Foul Mouth Kahan, man. And if I offended you, I meant to. Throughout the course of this video, truth will be told, and bullshit shall run a marathon. Now, to those of you that's been actually under a rock for the past week, and you're unaware, there's a major trucker boycott going on against New York City. And rightfully so. Why do you, Kahan tells the doc, agree with the boycott? Because I'm going to tell you something, man. If they could do this to a former president of the United States, then they could do it to anyone. If you got any kind of brain, you know what they doing to Trump is wrong. It's not about politics. It's not about Trump. If they could do this to Mr. Trump, then they could do it to any of us. Y'all don't have to get scared and keep falling out of the room. Pretend you got bad connections. I'm the one that's talking. Kahan tells a doc, so you know who said it, man. I know these other dudes are shook, man, but I'm here. I'm up in here, man. And the only way you're going to stop me is to kill me, man. You know what I told you? You don't have to be afraid. You don't want to come on here? Don't come on here. I'm talking, man. So the truckers are boycotting New York City, and rightfully so. And the same method that the truckers are using is the exact same thing that I have actually had called on every man in the world that has a joint swinging and a pair to stand up and boycott all family court systems throughout the world. Not just the United States, throughout the world. Because every man has a biased system against him. He gets the voice rate in family court. He gets his children taken away from him. So the truckers decided to stand up and boycott New York City. I don't know if you all know, man. 90% of everything that's utilized in New York City on a daily basis is brought in through trucks, not through their ports. I know I came out of New York City, man, but through trucks. You understand what I'm saying? Boy, this is a powerful movement. Why don't you men man up and stand up, man? I'm the voice. If you're afraid, stay on the sideline. Just sign the petition, man. And when I'm ready to make a move, all the lions are going to be up front. You understand what I'm talking about? All the lions. Oh, you sheep, just stay on the side, man. Cheer us on. Because you're not made for this. You're not built for this. 90% of everything, all of the items that go into New York that people live on a daily basis is brought in through trucks. They're boycotting it. They're feeling the effects. Jaidea, you in Israel, you better get the hell out of New York City, man. The spirit never leaves me wrong, man. Ever. The spirit told me, get out of here. Get out of Babylon. I left. I just obeyed. Now look, you know what's going to happen? Crime is already rampant. New York is a loser city. And I'm going to tell you this, if you're still in New York, you are a loser. That's a loser city, man. Look at what they're doing. I said it. Kahan tells a doc, so you know who said it. Tells a doc, Kahan. Twist it anywhere you want to. Yeah, I said it. New York is a loser city. And if you're still there, you are a loser. They got a governor, female governor, that's lost her damn mind, man. She say, I'm going to seize their bank accounts. Listen, man.
Wow.
I've been doing this for like 16 years. That woman is out of, she don't have no authority to do that. So you truckers that you think that woman has the power to do that, come over here. I'll show you. Matter of fact, let me put a link in the room and show you how to protect your bank account from liens and levies. Go on, tell the doc so you know who said it. I said it. How to protect your account from liens and levy, man. She has no authority to do that. You guys don't have to panic over that. She doesn't have that kind of authority. But then again, look at what they're doing to the former president of the United States. Totally unjust. There's a link right here. I'm about to post in the room. All of you people that drive trucks, you should be having all truckers tune into this, man. Any of them that's afraid, I'll show you. That link right there shows you how to secure your account from liens and levies. Understand that. Now, the same thing that truckers, I should have like 1 million signatures already, man. It's showing you the kind of men we're dealing with in this world, man. You guys are scarred. You understand what I'm saying? You scarred. Cowards, man. Real talk, huh? Because this is serious, man. Think about it, man. If they doing this to the former president, nobody else stands a chance, man. And it's unjust.
Come on.
This is unjust, man. They can't justify that, man. What are they talking about? 350 million?
Yep. That's what it say. He said you can't do business in
Can't do business in New York. So none of us do business there. It's easy. They go against their own laws. You know, you're when you deliberately break the law, you're no longer under sovereign immunity, man. You're no longer under that. So the only thing, man, that's required is for you men. You men need to stand up, man, and man up. You know the family court system is unjust. You know a lot of people are suffering from it. Stop bowing down to Eve, man. Stop bowing down to her. Akeisha James. Bragging. See, this is where Eve shouldn't be in power. That was an emotional thing, man. And desperately wicked.
First.
Now they crying because the truckers say, no, we truckers for Trump, man. Because not necessarily it's about Trump. It's about you being able to do that to any of us, man. There needs to be some liability, man, held for people that's doing things like this. Lakeisha James is a prime example why Eve shouldn't be in power, man. That's on everything I love. It's an emotional decision. It's unjust.